show that the evil and the tyranny are taking hold. And we must mention to you that a listener to our program, The Dog Cat Owl, has sent us an important article about the use of aspirin. And of course, aspirin has wonderful uses for cardiac problems. I watched my own father, who almost died of myocarditis, and that was an inflammation of the muscle of the heart. And he was a very sturdy man, and he was incapacitated for over a year. And I watched him because penicillin wasn't really being used then yet for this problem. And he would take maybe, 15 aspirin a day. And he would pop them into his mouth, and I would see his complexion go from gray to pink. And over a period of about 4 years, he really rebuilt his heart. But you don't want to be taking aspirin when you have the coronavirus. Now, here is an excerpt from Listener Al from the Phoenix Journal Review. And this was March 8th, 2006. Back, you see, it's kind of the bird flu. So we'll just give you a quick excerpt. By creating a fever, viral infection is slowed down sufficiently so that the body's T cells can find a small, infected blood cell, ions, and metabolite, literally eat the damaged cell with strong acids, which also breaks down the RNA viruses into basic amino acids. This effectively kills the viruses so that they can't reproduce. But viruses are not, something I don't agree with, so I just will skip that little part. That they're not living things. I may as well say what it is, and you can't tell them it's not alive. You think they are living, aren't they?
Well, that's a great debate. I think it all depends what you mean by
living. Right, then we won't get into that. But anyway, it's so important. All the body can do is destroy or dissolve the RNA amino acid chain, which makes up the virus. Not knowing this, most doctors treat the flu with aspirin or fever reducers. As a palliative treatment, they can use the aches, pains, and delirium fever. And the patient feels much better. What makes the patient or the doctor know is that with only a normal 98.6 degree Fahrenheit body temperature, the viruses are allowed to reproduce. Unchecked. Within 72 hours, the viruses have grown from one or two virus bodies to millions or billions. The body is now completely overwhelmed. But while taking aspirin or cold medications, there are no symptoms or worries of what is yet to come. And then the article goes on to say that as a last resort, the body tries to quickly flush the infection of billions of viruses from the lungs with massive amounts of T cells and fluid in the lungs to cough out the virus. This is called viral pneumonia. Soon within hours, the patient is in the hospital. The doctor tries to treat the now 105 degree fever with lower antifungal aspirin or related medications to quote treat the fever. Then within another 24 hours, the patient suffocating and gasping for breath is dead. So I believe that you can all be conjured by that. And we have an article here that I may have to abbreviate a little bit, but this is the question. February 26th at Natural News, did the 5G rollout in Wuhan damage the innate cellular defense cells of the population, putting the people at risk of complications and deaths from coronavirus? So the article looked very, very interesting because China had rolled out 5G in October 2019 in that province of Wuhan. And just 2 months later, the city, you see, got this new kind of coronavirus, which we believe from all reports is bioengineered. But what the question is raised by Natural News is, were these immune systems more compromised than normal? Were they more vulnerable because of the 5G? Does 5G cause severe inflammation, damaging the innate immune system? Could it be that 5G does cause DNA breaks, as documented by scientists? Do these DNA breaks potentially affect innate immune molecules, such as the nano-binding lectins, which are primarily located on lung surfactant proteins A and D? MBLs are powerful defense molecules that have been clinically studied to target coronaviruses early in their replication cycle, preventing viral attachment. If MBL levels are compromised through oxidation, respiratory viruses can more readily take hold of the human host. Deficiency in MBLs also occurs when there is a three single
point mutation. And Chuck goes on to talk about this, that actually what these MBLs do, they bind with sugars, allowing the protein to interact with many different kinds of viruses, bacteria, yeast, fungi, and protozoa, cloaked with such sugars. MBLs are unique because they can bind to the surface of microbes and activate the complement system in an antibody. They are one of the only antiviral systems that can break down the signature glycoprotein shell that surrounds all the viruses, including Ebola, SARS, and MERS. Deficiency in MANA's binding lectin, remember, these are those things that are on the lungs. He goes on to say that this can be linked to chronic, like a pulmonary disease, that these people may be genetically ill-equipped. They may not have the adequate number of these. So that's an interesting thing, too. Any people who have this kind of a COPD, you might be more prone to the coronavirus. With the launch of this 5G wireless radio, cause oxidative damage to innate immune molecules like the MANA's binding lectin and the samples of Wuhan, China. A very interesting question. We must zip on because we have so much important information to bring to you.
And now we have an article entitled Coronavirus on Track to Reach Every Country in the World. South Korea, Italy, and Iran see sharp increases in cases. This is by Arsenio Toledo, Monday, March 6, 2020, in naturalnews.com. Officials from the World Health Organization, WHO, warn that COVID-19 has the potential to infect people from every country on Earth. This announcement comes as countries all over the world are reporting a global increasing number of new cases. On Friday, WHO spokesperson Christian Lindmeier reported that the spread of COVID-19 is, quote, getting bigger, unquote. This grave warning comes a day after Tedros Adhanom, Director General of the WHO, suggested that the world is at a tipping point because the spread of the disease is currently outpacing efforts to contain it. Said, quote, the virus has pandemic potential. We are actually in a very delicate situation in which the outbreak can go in many directions based on how we handle it, unquote. In the past week alone, more cases have been reported outside of China than within. Since Monday, 29 different countries have reported their first cases of COVID-19. Among them, Nigeria and Brazil, the first sub-Saharan African and the first Latin American countries, respectively, to have confirmed cases of COVID-19. The cases in both countries came from people who had recently been to the region of Lombardy in northern Italy.
And we have to interrupt that on Wednesday, the day before, you're hearing the program on InfoWars. Quite a discussion, and I believe that Stuart Rhodes, the head of bookkeepers, called for Trump to stop the domestic flights. We don't think this will happen, but it's what should be done. Because Mike Adams talked a day or two ago that he believes very much that domestic flights are now spreading it. Do you see now it's reaching all the hinterlands of the world? Every last corner there, even into Africa. Go ahead, Lou.
That's right. I heard them say that it has spread to every continent in the world except Antarctica. And as I was driving back from the grocery store today, I heard them say that the first death had occurred outside of Washington State, a death in California.
Yeah.
Now back to the article. As of writing, a compilation of official reports is stating that there are 85,185 confirmed cases, including 2,924 deaths directly due to the disease or complications it brought about. A majority of these cases, about 95%, are in mainland China. On February 28th alone, seven different countries reported their first cases of the disease. Belarus, Lithuania, Mexico, Monaco, and New Zealand. Meanwhile, three other countries, South Korea, Italy, and Iran, are reporting alarmingly sharp upticks of 19 cases. South Korean President Moon Jae-in officially raised the country's infectious disease alert to red, the highest level. This contact number confirmed COVID-19 cases soared by
700 over the course of only a few days.
Government website, February 28th alone, the country gained an additional 256 new cases,
70% of which come from Daegu, South Korea's fourth largest city.
In Italy, over half of new cases, around 59%, come from Lombardy, the country's largest region, home to over 10 million people, or 16.67% of the country's entire population. 11 towns in the region have been put in lockdown since the night of February 23rd, quarantining over 53,000 people.